Hi, AT from CNC at Home. What I'd like to do today is talk about the Genmitsu 3018 Pro and some of the modifications that I have made to that. Starting with right here. In the front, I used the Genmitsu to actually cut these letters and numbers out of some 3M reflective tape and got those pasted to the front. So that was a nice little addition. Another simple change that I made was underneath the feet. These are not attached, but when I put this down on something, these are just little neoprene pads from an old mouse pad. I just cut up a mouse pad, put those underneath here, and those help insulate the noise, the vibrations from the CNC router into whatever surface I have it on. It makes it run so much quieter, and it holds it in place, which is nice. Another thing that I added right here is the drag chain. That allows me to take all of the wires for the spindle, for my sensors, I'll talk about later, and for the stepper motor, run them through the drag chain all the way across and then into the controller. That way, as the gantry is moving back and forth, these wires stay all nice and controlled. I attached the drag chain here using an extra bolt and T-nut from the original assembly kit. This end, I just used a craft stick. It's kind of like a tongue depressor or a popsicle stick. I just hot glued that onto the stepper motor and then attached that with some nuts and bolts that I had lying around. So real simple. Got that off of Amazon. I'll have a link below as to where you can get that. Another item that I added was this stop switch. This was relatively inexpensive, and I just wired that in. It connects right into the woodpecker controller. The cord I salvaged off of, it was an old cell phone charger, I believe is what that was, and I just wired that in. There's a series of pins down here for attaching a variety of things. This emergency stop is connected to, what is that, A1, I believe. And I attached those along with the other things using a pin kit. Let me grab that and show that to you real quick. Here's the pin kit. It comes with a variety of ends and pins for either doing male or female ends, and it has singles, doubles, triples, quadruples, so a variety of connectors. I was using the twins, so it was just two pins, so I needed a ground in for the switch. Got a spool of wire, it's red and green, that worked out nicely, and a crimper for crimping these pins on. It's very small, tedious work. The end result, however, is very nice. I purchased these clamps as well. They just slide right into the T-channel. Came in a kit of four of them. And then they're adjustable. This back nut, you can adjust the height. There we go. Get a good view of that. The back nut, you can adjust the height. And then you just spin this down. I did have to modify this main bolt. It was too long. It wouldn't fit underneath the Z gantry, so I just cut that down so it just clears. These clamps are a little large for the old 3018. They do a great job, and I can then use them on a bigger router if I ever get one. Another modification to the 3018 was the addition of some limit switches. They're kind of small. I did only add three limit switches. I added a X zeroing switch, a Z zeroing switch, and then in the back on top of the stepper motor, you can see here, then that's a Y zeroing switch. At some point, I do have these extra switches. I may wire in my maxes as well for X, Y, and Z. I've seen several people who've made some really nice fixtures for holding these limit switches. I was kind of low tech on this, and I used hot glue. I just used a little chunk of wood here that the switch can hit against. Hot glued this all on. The same with my X minimum. It just hits the gantry when it comes over. The Y limit switch just hits the edge of our table here when it gets back far enough. It works really well. It's been on there for a year now, and I haven't had any issues. You may have noticed on the front of my emergency stop button, I have a little 1/8 inch plug. That's for pin A5. That's the ZTouch Probe that you can use for zeroing your tool. I made my own touch probe out of a little angle iron of metal and some clamps. I'm not going to show that. I do have a new touch probe that I need to get wired up, and I will do that in a future video. But I'll just have it plug in here, and then there's just a wire that runs through the middle of my coil and then plugs into the back on the woodpecker controller board into pin A5. The 3018 comes with an ER11 collet nut and an 1/8 inch collet. I purchased an extra nut and I got a 1/4 inch collet. That allows me to run 1/4 inch bits. One of the 1/4 inch bits that I got was this surfacing bit. This is a CNC spoil board bit. It's a 1 inch diameter and it's used for surfacing. What that allowed me to do then was I just got some wood from the craft store. I used carpet tape, double-sided carpet tape, and stuck that down after cutting them to the appropriate width so I can still use my T-channel slots for my clamps. These have stayed on well, and to level this whole thing with the machine, because the platform was a little bit warped, I just took the surfacing bit and ran it across, just taking 1/10 of a millimeter at a time. Just ran it back and forth several times until this was nice and smooth. And you can see that the spoil board's done its job. I've made a few cuts in it. That saved my aluminum bed from getting all messed up. I believe those are the main modifications that I have made to the Genmitsu 3018 Pro. The machine's been a lot of fun, it's worked well, and I'm still enjoying using it. So I hope you found these modifications interesting and something you can make yourself if you want. I will have a list of all of these items that I purchased from Amazon available so you can get right to those.
Oops.
Hi, I'm AT from CNC at Home. If you like our content, help support our channel by clicking on subscribe and liking our videos. Thank you for watching this video. Have fun with your CNC at Home projects.